everyone. Today, we are going to talk about the fractals. We will see what they mean, where we can see them, and actually how much people know about it. I asked a few of my friends what they think about it and do they actually know what they mean. So one of them is a great artist, one of them is very good at math, and one of them is a great singer. So first of all, let's see what they think about it.
As someone who really likes to paint and express myself through art, fractals are not just useful in math and science. They can actually be really helpful to find some creative and interesting ways to do my paintings. To be honest, I haven't talked with my professors in school about them, but I know that they're all around us.
So far, I haven't had the opportunity to work with fractals that intensely, but I think that I could speak in the name of all of us when I say that we've encountered them at least once in our life, whether that was through decimal numbers or through fractions. Now, today we do possess a wider range of knowledge, which allows us to connect fractals with the rest of the world. For example, now we know that a fractal is actually a tree trunk or a stem of a tree. Now, we are children of the 21st century, and fractals are a fairly new topic, so it is not that possible for us to recollect so much information about fractals.
Believe it or not, fractals can be used in music, but most musicians have seen fractals in images and thought that actually it is used just in math, but then they discover a song made of fractals.
Fractals can also help you while you're studying to concentrate and to focus on what you're doing.
So then I found out that we can use fractals to compare it with our history. So then I asked my friend that really loves to discover more about our past. What does she know about the fractals?
Well, I already had a chance to meet with the term of fractals in my elementary school. For me, they represent some type of never-ending pattern or some type of cluster, if I can call it like that. We used it in my history class to describe the main events and main people of Second World War. I think it could be very useful in quite more subjects than just math, for example, history, art, and etc.
Computer science. And thanks to those powerful machines, a new era started in mathematics. New disciplines of mathematics made possible by the development of computer science. And one of the most famous examples of this is what we call the fractal geometry. Geometry was developed long, long time ago. We have talked about Plato and Pythagoras and others. And thanks to the computer, a new kind of geometry became possible.
So now you know what are fractals.
For the definition and origin of the word. So the fractals are geometric shapes that can be decomposed into smaller parts so that each of them is at least approximately a reduced copy of the whole. In addition to the fact they are broken is a characteristic of the fractals that the same shape is constantly repeated. If the same part of the fractals is inlaid, it will look like the whole fractal. The term fractal was invented in 1975 by Benoit Mandelbrot, French mathematician with a Polish origin. It comes from the word, Latin word fractus, which means broken or fractured. Next slide. So the characteristic of the fractal, it has a fine structure and artability small scales. It is too irregular to be easily described in traditional Euclidean geometric language. It is self-similar. It is a Hausdorff dimension, which is greater than its topological dimension, and it has a simple and recursive definition. So the fractals surround us, they can be found in various nature objects that surround us, such as clouds, mountain ranges, lightning bolts, coastlines, snowflakes, various vegetables, and animal coloration patterns.
So now I'm going to talk about more characteristics of fractals. Next slide. So we have different types of fractals. We have two types, fractals of complex number and system of iterative function of fractals. You have some pictures there in the corner. So properties of fractals, self-similarity, of course. Fractals are objects that contain themselves when magnified, and the fractal is similar to itself. Its parts look like it's a whole. They also can be divided based on the degree of the self-similarity. Also, fractal dimension that is not an integer. A fractal dimension is a value that gives us an insight into the extent to which fractals fill the space in which it is located. So we have topological dimension, which is integer, and the fractal dimension, which is not an integer. So fractals in math, of course, those are fractals of complex number. So Gaston Mauriso Juliet and Benoit Mandelbrot are two leading researchers in the field of complex number fractals, and that's Mandelbrot set and Julia's gatherings. You have pictures down there that represents that.
The fractal dimension. So first of all, we need to know some basics about dimension, I mean basic dimension, and we are not going to talk about dimensions that are higher than 3, because that is something more complex. And so we are all familiar with the three-dimensional world, we all live in it, and we have some objects such as cube and sphere, and they have three dimensions. Then we have two-dimensional world, and I mean two-dimensional objects, and those are circles and squares, for example. And we have even simpler, which is just one line, and it is one-dimensional. And simplest of all of them is the zero-dimensional object. I mean, it's just a small point that is infinitely small. So now when we know something about dimensions, we can see that we can calculate them by this formula, where we can calculate the number of objects in each dimension. So now let's talk about what is fractal dimension. Next slide. So it's an index of characterizing fractal patterns or sets by quantifying their complexity as a ratio of the change in detail to the change in scale, number like that. So we can see here that all fractals have dimensions that are fractions. And because, as it's obvious, it's not a perfect straight line, it's wigglier, but also it doesn't fill up a whole two dimension.
So now we're going to talk about Gottfried Leibniz. So the mathematics underlying fractals began to take shape in the 17th century. That's when Leibniz considered the property of recursive resemblance to himself. But he made a mistake when he thought that a straight line was similar to itself in that sense. Next slide. So he was a German mathematician, inventor, philosopher, lawyer, historian, diplomat, and political advisor. He was born in 1646 and he died in 1716 in Hanover. He made a significant contribution to optics and mechanics. And he is also considered to be the last man of encyclopedic knowledge of Western civilization. He was influenced by people like Plato, Aristotle, Descartes, and Christian Huygens. So fractals have not been present for a long time compared to known mathematical sets. But Leibniz came across fractals at the end of the 17th century while analyzing recursive self-similarity. He suggested the unique idea monology, basically when a particle contains another complete universe in it, such a universe must be again composed of much smaller particles, in each of which another small universe may repeat. So basically, if the universe were really formed in a fractal structure, we could say that our cosmos might be a particle too. Deciding that it was too difficult to deal with his new discoveries, using the available scientific tools of the time, he declared them to be as monsters, and he continued to bypass them. But in the 19th century, a second German mathematician, Karl Weierstrass, defined the first...
This is a short video of a fractal developing. I can guarantee that a lot of you watched the whole video. Why? Because the developer changed and altered all the warm and cold colors as the shapes. The developer made them attractive. And almost every program that has fractals allows you to alter the colors and the shapes of the fractal you produce.
Okay, so now I'm going to tell you something about fractals in the human body, actually in viruses and bacteria. Next slide. Okay, so here we can see some of the characteristics of viruses and bacteria in fractal geometry, like their binding functions, their positioning techniques, their methods of using to determine the chemistry of the body they have invaded, and how they will interfere with that body's chemistry. These are some of the most important viruses that have fractal structures. For the dynamics of AIDS virus in the human body, they have been modeled with fractal geometry. As the immune system begins to fall apart, the AIDS virus starts to behave chaotically. Studies of the virus at this stage have revealed significant changes in the fractal structure. For detecting cancer, the surface structures of cancer cell are crinkly and wrinkly. Using computers, mathematical pictures can be obtained, which reveal whether or not cells are going cancerous. The computer is able to measure the fractal structure of cells. The computer is able to measure the fractal structure of cells. If cells are too fractal, it means they are in trouble. And for the COVID-19, we have something more on the next slide. So the relevance of approaching the epidemiological curve as a fractal has advantages from two points of view. First of all, since the daily increase in the number of cases is rather irregular and hard to predict, the perspective of it as being a fractal might open a new way of predicting the evolution of the epidemic. Since the graph is fractal, besides being jagged and broken, it possesses some kind of fractal architecture that is prone to self-similarity. The similarity is a key element in assessing the current condition and predicting the next modifications in the epidemiological curves. On the other hand, regarding the epidemiological curve as a fractal and computing it as the result of fractal interpolation might be an effective means in reconstructing pieces of data that haven't been recorded. It won't reveal relevant information, but we will know that the epidemic curves resemble a fractal structure. In some observations, we know that fractal statistics study may reveal further information. Maybe fractals are just closer look to our natural world. Some scientists still believe that true randomness does exist and that no mathematical equation will ever describe it perfectly. Respect nature as you study it. Thank you for watching.